Not just the traditional defense names, by the way, that have been rallying as these tensions rise. The cybersecurity stocks themselves are up about 20% in the past month. My next guest is CEO of Tenable and is here to help maybe shed some light on whether any sensitive information might have been breached. He's Amit Yoran, CEO of Tenable. Thank you for coming in. Welcome. It's great to have you here. Listen, I mean, are you privy to any kind of special information about this situation? As a CEO of this leading cybersecurity company, what's going through your mind as you're watching all of these reports, trying to process it all?
Sure. Well, there certainly are cybersecurity concerns. When you look at the equipment that may be found and when we get a final report on what equipment was being carried on board with these objects, mm-hmm. we'll know a lot more about what type of communications may have been intercepted, what type of information may have been collected. And so certainly it is cause for concern.
Right. So, I mean, there's all... The problem is with premise, right? If the premise is this was definitely a spy balloon, then I could ask you a bunch of questions. If the premise is, nah, it just drifted off course, or, hey, this has been happening for a while, we're really only wising up to it, they just point in such different areas. What would be your main questions if you had a chance to examine these objects?
Yeah, well, I think the question is, you know, they were drifting off course and over very sensitive areas, so that seems highly unlikely. And the things we would want to know about these objects are more about the communications equipment that was on them. What sorts of sensing equipment are they able to intercept? What are they able to intercept? What were the things of greatest interest? What were the signals of greatest interest to the adversaries?
You know as well as anybody what information people can get through the internet, let's say, through hacking physical infrastructure and that sort of thing. Why a spy balloon? What can an aerial image or aerial surveillance offer that perhaps current firewalls or internet systems aren't allowing someone to penetrate in order to get at that kind of price information they might be looking for?
If you have physical proximity, you can do a lot of things that are much easier to do than trying to do them at a distance. So you could mimic cell towers, you could mimic communications equipment, you can intercept communications and understand what content is going through. So any sensitive information, any information about operations, any information and telemetry about what's occurring in that area, how systems are configured, those would be the types of things which you could intercept and really understand with a spy balloon.
So even in the digital age, there's still some value in kind of good old-fashioned spying.
Well, for sure there's value in good old-fashioned spying, and perhaps even more so in the digital age, because of the amount of information, the richness, the robustness of the information that you can collect and you can use.
So also implicit in all of this, as we figure out what was the deal with that balloon and the other objects and so forth, is the relationship between the U.S. and China as it relates to our companies doing business with them? Are we going to ban TikTok? All of these kinds of things. What's at stake for a business like yours in this relationship? Do you need this relationship to go well so that supply chains, for instance, aren't disrupted? Or do you need this relationship to turn more hawkish so that people feel an increased need to protect themselves against possible penetration?
Well, we are a software-based company, so we're not dependent upon the hardware or anything from China from a supply chain perspective. We believe fundamentally that every organization has the right to understand their cyber risk and to know what they can do to better protect themselves. And so to that end, to the extent that people feel threatened or feel like they need to increase their cybersecurity spending as a result of a spy balloon, then that's fine. But I think the fundamental premise, whether there's a spy balloon or not, is that the internet is a dangerous place and that organizations really need to understand, enterprises really need to understand what is at risk for them and how they can better protect themselves.
Final, I don't know if this is too much of a pivot, but in this sort of frenzy that we're having right now over new AI technologies, which are going to be deployed in enterprise with language capabilities to sort of scrape data and use it the way we're currently using the internet, what does that mean for a firm like yours? How do you make sure that you protect that data, maybe protect it from getting disrupted in some way? I'm just curious how big a deal you think this technology is.
Well, AI holds great promise. At Tenable, we use artificial intelligence to help understand what pieces of software and where vulnerabilities might be exploited. It helps our researchers provide better products and better capabilities to our customers. I think when you talk about general purpose AIs being broadly available, I think we're in very dangerous territory. I think we're going to see the doom and gloom and dark side of AI much sooner than people anticipated.
Why?
We don't have very good ethical models around how these technologies could and should be developed, and we have almost no control over them. So If you look at ChatGPT as an example, it's already been jailbroken. It's already outside the box. So it's accessing internet data. They have a jailbroken version called Do Anything Now, where they bypass the controls that we thought were in place. And so when you start collecting information, when you start tapping into the wealth of information on the internet, when you start tapping into social media, and you combine that with an advanced AI, really dangerous things can happen.
Do you think they should be shut down?
Well, I'm not going to stand here and say we should shut this particular AI down or that particular AI.
I mean, it's comical to even ask because we know we can't shut it down. But what you're saying suggests, and there are some who have criticized them for putting this out when they did and said, you know, you're polluting the current internet if you want to just create better models in the future, but also you're not necessarily equipping people with the tools of how to handle this. Did they jump the gun, in other words?
AI holds great promise and will be able to do amazing things. And you're seeing students and you're seeing researchers and you're seeing even ordinary consumers doing really interesting with ChatGPT. So I don't want to stand here and say, oh, this is bad, this is evil, this is a terrible thing. But I do think, if we aren't careful, when you look at the lack of controls around some of these AIs and the lack of good ethical understanding on how to use them and how they should evolve, I think we're on very thin ice and a very dark side of AI is probably going to come visit us soon.
Right. And you're supposed to be one of these people, like, oh, no, it's going to be great. It's going to be, no, not so much. Amit, it's great to have you. Thank you so much for your thoughts today. We appreciate it.
Great being here.
Amit Yoran with Tenable. Still ahead.